डॉक्टर जितेंद्र पांडे, माय कलीग इन आई स्कूल ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड आईटी, डॉक्टर मानस, डॉक्टर मैथिली, डॉक्टर रोज एंड ऑल आवर फेलो रिसोर्स पर्सन एक्सपर्ट्स एंड ऑल 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 दोज हु आर एनरोल्ड विद दिस दिस प्रोग्राम. सी आई एम एट द मोमेंट I'm director of the School of Computer Science and IT and online education at Uttarakhand Open University. And since it's an open university, therefore all pedagogical and all technology-enabled education, you know, and especially meant for remote learners and for all those who need it most, these technological things are there and it is on the way. And through this program, we just try to reach out to all those who really want to, you know, to get into the mode of further preparing MOOCs and further those who want to leverage technology in order to empower, in order to enable, you know, the learners. So we have this program and there we will be with you. So thank you very much and let us look forward to having a wonderful time. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Parth. Now I invite Professor Anirban Ghosh for a brief introduction. Your mic is muted, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Respected Dr. Durgaswan, Dr. Pandey, my colleague, Dr. Ashish, Dr. Moithili, and dear participants. Hope you are safe and well. The pandemic has shown us the importance and the potentials of digital platform. During the last 1.5 years, we are confined within the home. Right now, we are located at different locations, different places. For example, I am from West Bengal, Dr. Moithili and Dr. Ashish from Delhi, and other participants are spread all over the state of Uttarakhand. So, the digital platform has brought us in one place, and the objective is to learn. This particular FDP is specifically meant for the faculty. That's why we call it faculty development program. And during the last 1.5 years, most of us has completed some 2 or 3 online courses from different platforms like Coursera or something like that, and including Swayam from Indian perspective. So as participants, we got the output of the online learning material. We have experienced the online lectures, the e-content, the audio-video lectures, e-text. We have experienced all these things for the online learning. But how these are developed, what is going on behind the screen? That is our objective, to show you, or after completion of this course, you will be able to learn or understand how the online courses are developed. Though we have named it as the online course for development of Swayam, but if you complete this course successfully, you will be able to develop any online course which may be uploaded in your institutional LMS, or you may send your proposal to the Swayam board. Because nowadays, the online learning is the main issue to reach our students. Being the teachers of different spheres, it is our responsibility to engage our students to continue their studies. So how it is possible? The online platform, the digital platform, gives us the space through which we can teach our students, we can engage our students. So this course will give you an insight of the online courses, how these are developed. This FDP, this online FDP is also developed in 4-quadrant approach, which is followed in general for all type of online courses. So you should have a clear idea about the four quadrant approach if you wish to develop the online course. And I have also participated in the discussion forum. I have seen the participants are from different spheres or different domains of knowledge, different disciplines. So if you develop yourself for the development of the online course, it will be our benefit. These are our objective. The SEMCA and Professor Dr. Panigri is also present here. The SEMCA, UAU and IGNU people are engaged to develop this course. So I hope you will enjoy the program. And I am also participating in that discussion forum. I am trying to respond to those queries. I hope you will enjoy this program. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Pandey.
Thank you, Professor Anirban. Now I request Dr. Ashish for his introduction.
Thank you very much, Dr. Jiten. Respected Professor Durgeshman, Dr. Jitenji, Dr. Manas, Professor Anirban sir, and my respected colleague, Dr. Maithili, and all the respected participants, those who have joined in this forum across India. So my name is Ashish Kumar Awadhia, and I am working as the assistant director at Center for Online Education at Indira Gandhi National Open University. And basically, I am at the Center for Online Education, IGNU. I am looking after the activities of SWAYAM. And rightly, Dr. Professor Anirban said that like in this forum, there are participants from across India. Similar way, you can also have your class with students across India, and a student from a village, a student from a rural background. So you can see that we can teach the unreached learner through this platform. And I am also seeing your discussion forum. You all are very enthusiastic, and you have got lot of queries, and they are being solved. So I think this is very good platform, and we can discuss further now. Thank you very much, and over to Dr. Jitendra. Thank you.
Thank you, Ashish ji. And I am Dr. Jitendra Pandey. I'm working as an associate professor at Department of Computer Science at Uttarakhand Open University. And I am the course coordinator for this program. So now with the permission of the panelists, I declare the house open for questions. But before we start, I request all the participants to ask focused questions which are directly related to this course. And do not club two or three questions. Ask each question separately. And this session is recorded for future reference purpose. Now I request all the participants to put up their queries before the panelists.
May I ask a question? I'm Dr. Sriram Pandey from Banaras Hindu University. So I have a question to the panelists regarding these OERs. I have gone through the OERs common website, and I have seen that apart from these, all the licenses that is discussed over the tutorials also. And it is mentioned that this ND based licenses are highly discouraged for the creation of OERs. Although all CC license, as per my understanding, based on your tutorial, all these CC licenses gives a guarantees to ARI resource for the creation of OER. Why this ND based licenses cannot be used for creation of OER, or it can be used, whatever.
Actually, it is discouraged because OERs means open education license. And when the ND with ND condition, it is non-derivative. You cannot make any modification. You cannot revise it. You have to use as it is. You cannot make any modification. So that's why this ND is highly discouraged, and it is considered to be very closed, near to the copyrighted material.
So whether we can create OER based on these licenses, or certainly we could not create any.
You can OER. Always, you can use that, but again, you have to release that resource under, see, first thing is what license you are planning for the derivative work, right?
Okay.
If you are using ND, so you have to release your document as ND only, and you cannot not club it with your resource. Because you cannot derive anything from that resource. You have to share as it is.
But it is nowhere, sir, mentioned that, sorry to interrupt you, but it is nowhere mentioned that apart from SA license, it is nowhere mentioned that with the ND license, we could have to keep the same license. I have also gone through this adopter chart, and I have seen that I could not adopt, if the resource is given in ND license, I could not adopt any of the licenses.
Yes, that's what I am saying, what license you are planning. Since it is non-derivative, so you cannot use it with your existing material. And when you cannot use it with your existing material, there is no, you cannot share it, right? How can you share when you can share your resource, right?
Yes.
It is already, that resource, is owned by someone else. And so, he have given you the permission to use it without creating any derivative work. So, see, you can give permission to use your work, right?
Okay. But I could not adopt if it is ND. I could not adopt the material.
You cannot incorporate it. You can use it. You can share it for teaching purpose, for non, depends on whether it is NC or not. But you cannot use it and adapt it for creating another resource.
Okay, thank you so much, sir.
It was myself, Vivek Sharma. My question is that how we can identify those licenses if any material which is widely available on the internet. So how we can identify that a particular material is having this license, whether it's a CC BY or a CC BY NC, whatever it is.
There are, two strategies. First is you go to the place, OER platform, where all the material that is released under open license. I have shared a link with you all as an activity. That was a platform which contains all the resources which are released under Creative Commons open licenses. Second strategy is use Google Advanced Search. If you use this, there is an option at the last where it asks for the type of license, whether you are looking for all the resources or whether you are looking for the content which are released under open license or Creative Commons license. If you click on that tab, and if you type the keyword after that, if you go through the video, I have shared some screenshots also, then if using Google Advanced Search, you can easily find the OER material on the internet.
So along with the license, which license it is.
At the bottom of the page, the license terms are dictated.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Hello, my name is Kaustubh. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. First, I want to congratulate the entire Uttarakhand University for designing such a wonderful course. So my congratulations to everyone who is involved from bottom to the top. I have three questions. Let me raise it one by one. My first question, what is the first quiz like? Is it based on the reading material that you have shared, or it is based on our understanding?
Both.
Okay, all right. Understood. My second question. As a learner, what should be the first step? Choose a topic to design, which fortunately I have chosen one, and then move further step by step as we will be instructed, or the UOU will assign a sample topic and take all of us through.
You are asking about SWAYAM course?
Yes, this course itself.
No. I mean, for this course, I mean, there are certain lectures in order, which are placed in order.
All right.
So, because some people feel, I mean, they face trouble, sequencing the, lectures. So we have, arranged the lectures in the form that, I mean, they are logically flowing from one topic to other and other to, I mean, second to third, third to fourth.
No, Dr. Bhade, let me repeat the question once again, I believe. I'm asking, as a learner, what should be my first step? Should I choose my topic, which I am likely to design tomorrow after completing the course? So should I choose the topic first, or you will guide us through by giving us a sample topic and help us to move along?
Okay. What I have understood is you want to design a course for SWAYAM.
Yes.
And you want how to take it further, right?
Yes, sir. Well, I'm not saying I want to design. Understand or share somebody.
Okay.
The best approach
is you go through the, EOI of all the national coordinators. I mean, they have prioritized the area, specific areas where the lectures, the courses are required.
All right.
It generally does not depend on your interest. It is, normally what subjects they have, identified for which they require some courses.
Sir, is there any list which is available on any platform of the courses which they require?
If you go through SWAYAM, all the national coordinators are listed there. You go through their website and they, invite the EOI, expression of interest. You go through their notification,
list of national coordinator, of course, is there. We are having the website also, but the list of the certain areas where the SWAYAM course is to be developed, whether it is available on any platform, mean to say that on any national coordinator.
Depends on the national coordinator, because they all have different focus areas.
Okay. Somebody else is having and the technical education, the NEPTEL is there, but various area for which a course is to be developed, such a list is there on any national coordinator's platform.
If you may I add, Doctor, may I add something? Suppose you want to develop a course for UG course, UG undergraduate course. So you may visit the UOI InfliNet site. There you will get the list of courses for which they are asking for.
Dr. Anirban, you may.
If you want to develop a course for undergraduate, so you may visit the EOI portal of InfliNet. It is now open. If you are interested, you may visit that InfliNet portal for expression of interest. There you will get the list of courses in drop-down menu for undergraduate course only, because CEC deals with the undergraduate courses. So if you can select any one of them, and the syllabus is based on the CBCS as prescribed by the UGC. And accordingly, you have to develop the proposal and submit the proposal through online. This is simple. And for submission of EOI in SWAYAM, you have to submit the declaration from your parent institute also, that they are agreed to conduct such and such course, because the certification will be done jointly by SWAYAM national coordinator and the parent institute, your institute, who is offering the course. These are modalities. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
That's it.
And Dr. Nathalie has already shared the link in the chat box. So kindly go through it. It is already shared.
Sure, noted. My last question, Dr. Pandey. Assuming that the learner has passed this course, so my next question is how he or she will start assisting, coordinating, shadowing So what is the roadmap like?
See, this FDP is how to develop a course for Swayam. What are the four quadrants, right? Otherwise, while developing the, you know, the instructions are given in the Swayam manual, I mean, regulation 2017 that we have already shared. You have to follow those steps. You have to, you know, respond to the EOI. But, you know, once that is approved, how can you take it further? I mean, how to prepare a program for Swayam? This is the main purpose of this FDP program. If required, we can share a sample course proposal also. So how to make a course proposal in the second interaction. And based on that, you can prepare your EOI. Hosting a course in Swayam, it depends on, you know, whether a Swayam board approves it or they don't approve.
I have understood Dr. Pandey that very clear about it. I'm only asking, suppose I have completed this course, how I become, start learning, contributing. I at least bother whether my name appears as a, you know, full-fledged, you know, course developer. How do I become contributor? Even if it's a small work, how do I start? How do I start something, you know, doing something? So I feel that I've done this course and I've begin to contribute. Wow,
absolutely right. If Dr. Pandey allow me, let me just discuss with Dr. Carvey. Am I spelled your name rightly, Carvey?
It's all right, sir. Name doesn't matter.
Great, sir. And sir, nice, very good question this is. Actually, your question is reflecting towards the outcome of this course. Actually, your concern is that after completion of this course, what supposed to your role? And number one, number two, how you can become engaged yourself in the content what you have learned from this course. So this is my I can just rightly let you know, because if I will know your profile, where you are placed, if you are working in a university or in a college, so this course helps you. After completion of this course, you are able to, means this course expects, particularly course organizers expects from you that you are developing your contents, and particularly e-contents, means online contents, which can use different ICT tools, which is available as per your knowledge concern. And using that ICT tools, you can reach to your students, number one. Number two, you can engage your students, not only just synchronous for the specified lesson period, beyond that, in asynchronous also, you can connect it with your learner to provide continuous support in their learning. This is one. Another one is being a teacher, you can connect it with the various domain teachers in that area, bringing them and connecting to your learners, making their learning happening and joyful. So this course gives you the strength. When you will complete this course, this will give you the strength that you can develop some aspects of online contents, which you can deliver through various available platforms. This is not only just for the Swayam. If you are interested for the Swayam, then you can move towards the Swayam. There are process what Professor Anirvan Ghosh said, as well as Dr. Pandey is sharing with us. Other than that, if you want to engage yourself with your learners continuously and comprehensively in their learning, participating in their learning and engaging them in their learning, not only just in the what is called domain of psychomotor, you can move to the beyond that and higher order thinking. So this will help you to create your own contents, which you are teaching in the classroom and engaging them virtually. And you learned that pandemic has really taught us that how we can reach to our learners. I found from various research studies, particularly UNESCO and Commonwealth of Learning come out with that, we have the good quantum of learning loss in that 16 months. Our students are unable to access to university or the institutions. Our students are unable to access to their teachers. Even our students are unable to access to their library, which is more important thing that to make them learning happening. So all these are closed and our learning is stuck on, and which is resulted to the learning loss. And this learning loss can be verified and making it in a such a way that this course will help you to make this happening for your learner as well as yourself, which you are missing to connecting with your learners. This is my answer. I hope I tried to answer your query.
Unfortunately, I have no professor, but I had a chance or opportunity to teach college for 2 years continuously. But coming back to my request, I am ready to assist any one of you, any one of the panelists. Feel free to connect with me if I can contribute to you by any means. And forget about my name or the anything in return. I'm
available. Great, sir. We are definitely connected with you, and with your profile, we will definitely make you in the team so that we can serve our learners, and we can able to reach to that bridge that learning loss.
Sure, I am available.
Thank you very much. So, any other? Over to Jitendra ji.
Next question.
Sir,
good evening, sir.
This is Purnima. Hello?
Yes.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes.
So this is Purnima, actually Galiviti Purnima from Presidency University of Bangalore. So I have two questions. First one is the PhD mandatory to develop a MOOC course for the SWAYAM? Sir?
You can be one of the contributor, but you cannot be a course coordinator. Because for that purpose, you need to have certain number of years of experience. Then only you can apply. Again, it depends on. It differs from coordinator to coordinator, national coordinator.
In that way, I have totally 14 years of teaching experience with a 1 year of industry experience, and I've gone through the website what Dr. Maithili ma'am has shared already. I've identified one language called R. So I wanted to process with the development of the course for that. Will I be eligible?
Dr. Ashish.
Yes. Purnima, basically, first you have to see for which level or which sector you want to go. Accordingly, you see which national coordinator will suit your course. Okay. Then you have to go to the national coordinator requirement, and then you can apply. Because a requirement of every national coordinator varies from their priority. Okay, so and in that way you have to go. So if you want to go to CEC, they have something different requirement. If you want to go to IGNU, we have something different requirement. So that is the thing. That's why in the expression of interest, if you see the guideline also, in expression of interest, there is a first section is there for profile of the proposer. A person who is proposing a course, there is a clear requirement. What is the name? What are the qualifications? What is the criteria? What is the experience? Okay, guidelines doesn't define any particular experience or criteria. So this is the national coordinator who will decide the criteria or experience, whatever you say. So you first see the requirements of the national coordinator, accordingly you proceed.
So I have a second question. So if I have to propose...
Yeah, can I get in?
Yes, sir.
Just to add on to the previous one, Ashish, I want to add on. This is the eligibility is clearly mentioned in that project in Swayam platform. That is the teacher or the faculty who have a PhD degree with 5 years experience in the concerned discipline in a university, then they can able to submit the EOE for the for Swayam for to offer the course in Swayam. That is the eligibility condition. Okay, so if any Ashish said that they have to develop the proposal, submit through their own concerned department through approval from the vice chancellor, you know, to the national coordinator, then only it will be accepted. Yeah, over to you.
Okay,
and
now
sir Michael Bhuneshwari, good evening, sir. Sir, my question is, while preparing e-content or e-tutorial, preferably what type of diagrams or pictures can be imported from what other sources? What type of copyright a picture or a diagram requires to be used in an e-content or e-tutorial which we are developing?
You can use OERs, Open Educational Resources. Just like, you know, you search the text content, you can also search for the images. Go to the Google Advanced Search, mention the copyright terms, and then you can search for the related images. Otherwise, you can draw it yourself. Copyright concern is always there.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Good evening, panel members. Sir, this is Dr. Sumit Gupta from University of Petroleum and Energy Studies, Dehradun. Sir, I have two questions rather. Sir, one is that for Swayam, I offer myself if any support required from my side to mentor or to support any course, I'm available. Doesn't matter, sir, what you offer, because I'm available for help. So second, for Swayam, sir, how we can become a mentor? Because there's a link for mentor. I checked the NAPTEL, there's a link for mentor, but how it will be, like how we can become a mentor?
Connect yourself to the course coordinator of that particular course that you are interested in to mentor.
Okay.
That team will decide.
Okay, done. Thank you.
Thank you.
Dr. Gupta,
want to answer.
Very much.
You can also visit the NCCL.
Let me just add one point to this. Thank you very much. You are extending your help to this course. Though you are enrolled in this course, I hope you can help us in the responding to our participant query, because you are having first-hand experience. You are hosting one course in Swayam. So I hope and I believe that you can help us in this way, that responding to some of the queries of our participants in the platform itself. Thank you very much, Sumit.
Sure, sir. I will do that.
I would like to request Dr. Jitendra Pandey, can we go with those who raised virtual hand only? Because that will can make disciplines to discuss and cover more questions and go to more questions.
We'll follow this order. Whoever will, raise the hand virtually, we'll allow them and we'll, I'll call the name. He or she will ask the question.
Okay. Absolutely. Grateful you.
Dr. Purnima Swaroop.
Hello, good evening, everybody. I am Purnima Swaroop, Director, School of Nanotechnology, Rajiv Gandhi Technical University, Bhopal. First of all, I must thank all the organizer for designing such an interesting course and giving us opportunity to improve our teaching learning practices. So thank you so much. The course is also very well designed, and I have started learning a few things to improve my online lecturing. I already do it through Moodle, which our university have the portal. So I tried to prepare small videos of my lectures, in which Dr. Nisha's videos were there, and I tried to make my video through PPT. And I preferred MS Office version 10. My system is licensed for that. But that video cannot be created. Do we need any additional feature to be added? Actually, while preparing the video on MS Office PPT, the video options were not visible in my system. I have Windows 10. So can you guide, do I need to add any additional feature to
You require some screen recording software like FreeCam for recording the screen.
Which is open source.
Yeah, it is free of cost.
FreeCam, if I download, and how to merge it with PPT to prepare a video? Actually, I just need some guidance for preparing small videos of my teaching.
Dr. Maithili.
Dr. Purnima, my name is, you can connect with me. I can solve your problem.
Okay.
Sir, can I add something over here?
Thank you so much, Kaustubji. Thank you all.
Sure.
Vivek, sir, can I add something?
Sure.
Well, Dr. Purnima, I believe that you are using the Windows 10, but at the same time, when you are using the Office, perhaps your Office is the older version, maybe a 2007. So go for the 2013 Office, and that will help you in making the videos along with that.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you, Vivekji. Now, Pooja Paliwal, you can put up your question, please. Is she available?
I think she left. We can go.
Venkatesh Kumar. Venkatesh ji. Shruti. Okay.
Yes, sir. So I hope I am audible enough.
Yes.
Yeah. So my very good morning, good afternoon to all the panelists here. So my question is that I have been reading the guidelines for Swayam, and as per the guidelines for developing a MOOC course, for example, suppose I am from the computer science department. So let's just say I want to develop a course for C++. Okay. So there is that guideline that it has to be approved from the university academic council. So does that course have to be approved as a MOOC course, or because C++ we have that as part of our BCA course or as part of our PGDCA course, or so does it have to be approved separately as a MOOC course, or since it's a part of an already ongoing course, so it's already approved? So sir, what is the guideline over here? It's not really clear to me.
Okay. May I answer this?
Yes, sure.
Dr. Shruti, basically in Swayam, when you are offering the MOOC, so it is even it is approved by your university council, that is being in face-to-face mode, but you have to take an undertaking from the university saying that the university will be responsible to take the exam and give the credit to the learner. Accordingly, this consent is required. Even your course is already running and it is approved from the academic council. For Swayam, you have to give a separate certificate, that is consent from the host university. That certificate is required.
Okay.
This is basically to facilitate.
It is a part of, that certificate is a part of UI also.
You cannot apply any proposal.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Without.
Yeah.
Sachin Kumarji.
Okay, sir. Sir, I had one more question, if you permit me.
Okay, you can put your question. Please, fast.
Okay, so actually, I've gone through the SWAM site, and they are asking for proposals right now, but there is no end date there given there. So could you let us know if you know something about the last date for submitting proposals there? Thank you so much for answering the questions.
May I?
Yes.
Yeah, basically, Dr. Shruti, this EOIs are generally most of the national coordinators, they keep it on ongoing basis, okay? And they have their own meetings. So they are ongoing basis, and whenever they have their meetings, they take those proposals, they scrutinize them, this proposal, and once they are approved, they approve them for the subsequent cycle. Because SWAM courses are offered in two cycles, January cycle and July cycle. So you propose and accordingly they approve it.
Okay, fine. From now onwards, only one question, please, because we are running out of time. Only one question. One participant, one question. Dr. Manisha Karakoti. If you are available, please ask your question.
Hello.
Okay, you are available. Okay.
Hello. Yes, good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Hello.
Yes, I'm you are audible. Sir. Please ask your question.
Okay. Sir, I just wanted to ask a question. Sometimes the students.
Audible.
Hello.
Yes. You are not audible. Please speak loudly.
Good evening, all.
Yes.
Sir, please thank you so much for this course. Actually, I have one question that sometimes students require a PPT in Hindi. Hello?
Sir, yes.
Sometimes students require a PPT in Hindi, and this is very difficult for us to change a language from English to Hindi for preparing a PPT. So what do we have to do?
To go to Google Translator and convert that text and make some necessary correction.
So some supporting
the perfect translation. That. I don't think we have any free tool for that. Would you like to throw some light on this, Dr. Ashish or Dr. Maithili? Free tool for transcription in Hindi.
Is not available. It will create
even the
problem.
Paid tools
also,
are not perfect.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, paid tools also not possible. But what C is asking is while preparing the PPTs, you want to put a, Hindi words and Hindi typing sometimes.
Some Hindi material also, I want to add them.
So,
for the students, for the better understanding.
See, when you are typing, you can see that there is a left side corner. It's a English, that keyboard is there, English keyboard and all. And you can switch to the different keyboard by clicking that one, and you can preferably select the Hindi keyboard, and then you start typing the thing. As well as But when it is saying, like Dr. Jitendra said, that Google Translator, you can type it and you can make changes of little word appropriately, and then you can copy and paste it in your PPT also. That is also very easy way to do it. So in this way, you can do in your PPT using English, Hindi typing.
Thank you, Dr. Maithili. Now I invite Mukul Kulkarni. You can ask your question, please.
Hello?
Yes.
My question is with Dr. Purnima's question. She wanted to develop some videos of our teaching by using some presentations along with our own video of talking and expressing. So actually, I think most of us is having similar kind of queries. I'm requesting, if it is possible in next session, can we have a demo of such kind of recordings? it was regarding Office 2013 or Office 365, how to use it and how to prepare effective videos so that we can engage students more effectively and attract them for learning.
See, the focus of this FDP program is different. We are not talking about the tools. We are talking about the strategies. We can definitely forward you some links or videos which are useful for you to prepare short videos. You can post your question in the discussion forum and we'll try to provide some supplementary material on that. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Dr. N. Sudha.
In connecting with this question, the recording of the video and all, I would like to emphasize here is, see that while recording for the video for SWAYAM, for your own purpose, you can select any type of any software or any tools to record the small short video and all. But when you are going for the SWAYAM, and SWAYAM, they have maintained some quality parameters. We have to meet that quality parameter to record the videos because one is the payment involvement, and then there should be a technical review is also there along with a content review. So we have to follow, and later, whatever the video you are developing for SWAYAM, it will be offered in the SWAYAM Prabha also for the video telecast. So we have to maintain the quality. So for that, whatever video you want to record for the SWAYAM, you have to select some studio for better resolution and better output.
You have to record in the HD quality. So you have to follow the norms. For your teaching, you can use any tool, but for SWAYAM, there are certain requirements that you need to follow. Next question from Kaushik Banerjee.
Am I audible?
Yes, yes.
Can I ask? So this FTP is actually has given answers to many of the questions which I had in my mind. I have one small question. So when we look into the syllabus, which is given for EOI at implement.ac.in, and I belong to the physics domain, some of the syllabus is very huge. And as a beginner, if I want to develop a course for MOOC, should I adhere only to that syllabus, or can I take part of that syllabus and develop my MOOC course? Should I strictly adhere to that syllabus, which is given in the implement.ac.in.
You have to follow the model syllabus provided.
Strictly have to follow. I cannot take a part of it.
But don't. Ashish, would you like to answer this? As per my understanding, you have to follow
because
the model syllabus
beginner,
of the respective regulator.
I feel a little. Okay.
You have to follow model syllabus. And you have to take a part containing. So you have to select in such a way that your whole course. Cover some particular topic, and if it is a 4-credit course, it should have 40 videos, and that's all those things should cover. You cannot take whole component. You have to take as basically it should be. If you see about credit course definition, what the credit course definition says that the credit course, any course which will be called credit course, which is being taught in the university for at least one semester. So accordingly, you have to appropriately go ahead.
Okay, sir.
So we'll try to wind up in another 15 minutes. Quick questions. Dr. Deepthi Joshi.
Good evening, sir. I'm audible.
Yes.
Am I audible?
Yes.
Thank you so much for taking my question. I would like to ask that is there any specific procedure to conduct exam for that particular course, or we can conduct it either online or offline?
Ashish ji, Maitli ji, your domain.
Examination will be conducted by NTA. So the institution cannot conduct the exam for SWAYAM. If you are if you are offering any course through SWAYAM, the examination will be taken care by the NTA. So the timely, they will ask the course coordinator to develop the question paper. Once they have developed the question paper, then this examination will be conducted by the NTA, and the papers will be coming to the coordinator to evaluate the evaluate the exam paper. So all are through online only. You no need to go for anywhere. So it's everything is online. They will timely give the link to upload the question paper, and timely they will give the link to evaluate the paper also. Because this will be taken care to provide the certification. And if you have any internal mark, you have to club with the internal mark along with the NTA marks to give the certification. And later it will be helpful to the institution to carry the credit transfer to include in the whole program. So that is mandatory. The NTA only will conduct the examination.
Thank you, Dr. Maitli. Now I invite Dr. Pramod Joshi.
Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible. Please ask your question.
First of all, thanks to be a part of this 2-week online FDP program organized by UOU. Dr. Pandey, I congratulate Dr. Pandey, Panigrahi also here with KEMCA, all respected members. But my question is, I'm just watching for a very long time, but I'm asking a question for SWAYAM organizers. If SWAYAM are deciding to move in next level up to like STEM education, which is an interdisciplinary approach to learning that integrated 4 discipline like science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, is this which is achieved the economic and technological advances to establish a link between school and industries? Is this type of planning of SWAYAM, the next future planning, is it possible or not, which is beneficial for the economy?
Just let me answer, try to discuss on this issue. If you will look into the Government of India's new education policy 2020, Dr. Joshi, you are absolutely and rightly pointed out the things which is talking more about the interdisciplinary. That interdisciplinary approach, which is main concern in through the new education policy, which believes that to at least it can help for the economic growth and contribute towards the people's better livelihood. So this is good, right thing you have pointed out, and looking towards the science, engineering and other things, what I believe SWAYAM also offering few courses, which is microcredit and non-credit professional development courses. Through this, no doubt, ImpliNet and other NTPL also, they are also offering various courses through this area. And however SWAYAM is concerned, definitely there are development which is moving towards, but more focused towards the SDG 4, Sustainable Development Goal number 4, what achievement looking for that 30-30, that the enrollment and access to education is more important, which moving towards more towards adding into the undergraduate and postgraduate programs. And absolutely that in your future and with the help of all academia, it is definitely possible, and SWAYAM people are looking for this ambience as well. Thank you.
Can I go ahead with the small ones?
Sure, sir.
Dr. Jitin. See, this is very interesting because Dr. Joshi is talking about STEAM, that is science, technology, engineering, mathematics. So that is STEM. And when arts is also, humanities is also clubbed into it, becomes STEAM. So these days, not only this, they are also talking in terms of STEAM, that is, environment is also added to it. Having said all that, see, when we talk about MOOCs, when we are talking about SWAYAM, so it's a platform. It's for online course dissemination, where you have different quadrants. But we have national coordinators for science, for technology, for engineering. And again, with science, we have mathematics domain. So all those things are there, and you look up to, like we are saying, this expression of interest is there, you find out. So in all, in that association, it becomes esteem. Yes, it is up to that teacher. Basically, the whole intent, the whole philosophy is as to how teachers take this education forward, as to how they take this entire philosophy forward. That's the whole crux. Yes, you have some idea, an interdisciplinary idea, and wherein you have experts from all across. Maybe you can just try out, and with this expression of interest, if there is any such interdisciplinary thing, you can go ahead with this. It's already inscribed. It is already encapsulated within the very premise of Swayam. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
In addition to this, Professor Pant, in addition to this, I just wanted to add to your words that, you know, we are always looking from the side of the learner. Actually, Swayam giving that privileges to the learners to pick their courses. There is no foundation to that for your learning. If I am a student of engineering, I can choose any social science or humanities or commerce and business. I can choose any one of the course out of these or many of the course out of these for my learning. And acquisition of the credits, that's all about the system, what the university where I am domiciled to, that that is the concern, that whether that credit is added to that or not. Yes. However, the national education policy rightly said that now universities are also looking into that consideration, how they can strengthen that choice-based credit system. So in that choice-based credit system, they are picking some of the relevant courses, which is, you are absolutely rightly said, Professor Pant, that STEM is now become more vibrant, and universities and institutions looking towards the implementation of a interdisciplinary approach in the course, they can picking few courses and allowing few courses in their own basket, which their learners can get access through the Swayam and get the course done, earn their credits, and which can be transferable to their university. This is no doubt. This is very good, Professor Pant. You are nicely pointed out.
Thank you very much.
Now I invite Ravi Tiwari ji for question. Your question, please.
Good evening, sir. Sir, my
please put up your question.
Sir, my question is, in Swayam, let's suppose I just develop a video in English language, but I want my course to be accessible for all over India, means in some regional language also. So is there any tool to transfer that particular video course into another regional language also? Because obviously Swayam is accessible for all over India. So is there any tool is available in Swayam by which I can convert my video into automatically in from one language to another regional language also, like Telugu, Malayalam?
Swayam is taking care of this. I mean, they are converting the content into the regional languages. They are providing transcript.
Yes. Okay.
Maybe Dr. Maitli would like to throw some light on this, or Dr. Ashish, because they are handling this.
See, Swayam is having, as you rightly said, that Swayam is having the provision of transcription is one of the part in first quadrant itself, because when you are going for the e-content, e-tutorial, so after developing the video component, then we have to transcript that video. So transcript, in the sense, whatever language you are speaking in the video also can be in different language, you know. Yes. That is also the regional languages is also allowing, Swayam is allowing. So you are transcripting into the English transcriptor, English. Then later, if you can see the Swayam portal itself, there are transcription also there. And also we are in IGNU, if you are talking about, if I want to talk about my own experience about in IGNU. So all the courses, all the video program is converted into the transcription is getting ready. After that, we asked our regional center to transcript in their own, expert from the regional center to translate into the languages. So our videos, mostly 8 different languages, they have translated in the last lockdown. We have did this exercise. So that will be available so that all over India who are want to listen through in their own language, then they can listen it. So it is there in the guidelines itself, they are mentioning we have to go to the transcription. From there, the translation will take place.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you.
And one more thing I want to add is the transcription is the responsibility of the course coordinator. Okay, the course coordinator, irrespective of any SMEs, subject matter expert, that the responsibility for the course coordinator is they have to convert that videos, all the videos into, get ready the transcription.
Okay, thank you.
Now I am taking the last question of the session. Ms. Reggie, you can put up your question, please.
Good evening, sir.
Please ask your question.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes.
Sir, my question is, I am from history discipline. I'm teaching history in a college, a remote place in Kanyakumari district, the southernmost district of India. My question is, can we have a regional history in Swayam course? Can we have a course like regional history, history of Kanyakumari?
Actually, we have already pointed out that it does not depends on your choice. I mean, yes. Your choice should match with the listed courses that are available. I mean, that the, Swayam National Coordinator have invited.
Mm-mm-mm.
If that course is there in that list, you can always apply. Otherwise, local, I mean.
When I search for history discipline, it is given as local history. Then can I apply for that?
I mean, the syllabus is also provided.
So
you match the syllabus, you match the content, and based on that, you can always apply.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
So now I invite the panelists for their closing remark. I'll start with Manasji. Your closing remark, please.
Thank you, Dr. Pandey. This is really very nice and interactive session. For me, but basically, though I can say here we have covered many things and we got many insights which we are put the thought for the discussion in our course itself. So which we expected in the course itself, how this course. Lata Arya, please mute yourself. Dr. Lata Arya, please mute yourself. Thank you very much, Dr. Thank you, Dr. Lata. So, what exactly we thought that this FDP will bring changes for the learning that is happening today when we are interacting with our participants. And I believe also my colleagues and the instructors and mentors, they agreed with me that the course, the such a way it has been developed and giving the space for the thinking. And that thinking is happening among the learners, which reflected in the forum, as well as we found this is also reflecting this live session. With these words, I request all our participants, please be connected with the forum and ask your as much as queries. And you also be requested to answer other queries who are raising. It is not necessary that instructors and mentors will back to your response. If any one of us knows the response, we can respond in that forum. So with these words, Thank you very much, Uttarakhand Open University, taking this nice initiative for live first live session. And thanks a lot to Professor
Thank you, Manushji. Now I invite Dr. Maithili for her closing remarks.
And
okay, sorry.
Thank you very much to my colleague and my friend, and I believe my brother, Professor Durgesh Pant, and he guiding rightly in the right time. And we enjoyed his presence. Thank you very much for your presence and spending entire this long period of time this evening. Thank you very much, sir. Over to Jitendraji.
Thank you, Manushji. And now I invite Dr. Maithili for her closing remark.
Thank you very much. First of all, I'll thank Dr. Professor Pant, sir, director. And Dr. Jiten, Professor Anurban, Dr. Manas, and Ashishji, so and all dear participants, because this is very fruitfully interaction in this evening, because all is related to the Swayam, and which is very much clear that participants are very much interested to create the Swayam courses, which are the need of ours, because we have to move towards the creation of the courses on Swayam platform to facilitate all our learners. That is very important, because and moreover, if you are creating that course, it will be very interesting to provide the content, you know. So I have a good experience by developing the two courses on Swayam, which is offering, and along with my friends Anurban sir and Jitendra, they also contributed. See, while developing and interacting with the participant on the online, it is very much interesting, and also we are learning towards that one, because each time we learn something while offering the course. That is very important. And I would lastly emphasize that whatever you are developing the course, providing the content, asking the ISMEs to develop the content, e-content, and everything, discussion forum is very important, where we are asking the participant to interact with us. Because online course should focus on interaction. So for that, the discussion forum is allowing in the Swayam platform. Concentrate on that part also to interact with the participant. With this, I thank all of you. Over to Pandeji.
Thank you, Dr. Maithili. Now I invite Dr. Ashish for his closing remark. Please unmute your mic.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Pandey. Respected Dr. Durgesh sir, Manasji, Dr. Anirban, and my respected colleague Maithili, and our respected participants. It was really very good to interact with you, and the type of questions raised in this forum were really very good, and what I think that this course has really provoked the participants to think a lot. It means the course has built in such a beautiful way and designed in such a way that I can say still there are 163 learners, and at the time I was admitting them, there was more than 200 learners. So more than 200 participants. So this shows that the course has been developed in such a way that participants are engaged and they are asking such a wonderful questions, means they are thinking and they are going through the course. So I congratulate to all the participants, and I congratulate to Uttarakhand Open University and SIMCA for designing such a wonderful course. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ashish ji. I just want to share some facts. There were around 1670 registrations, and there are around 750 active learners who are taking participating in all the activities. Now I request our own Professor Durgesh Pant for his closing remarks. Durgesh sir, please.
Thank you, Dr. Jitendra, for this extremely, extremely insightful and illuminating session. Always, it's a pleasure, you know, to get associated, especially when it is kind of a gyan yagya. So I marvel at the kind of, you know, this ecosystem that technology has given us. The very senior teacher, she was asking a question right from Kanyakumari, from Kerala. And we in Uttarakhand are responding. And we had this thing, Dr. Manas sitting in Delhi, Dr. Maithili, and Dr. Ghosh in Calcutta, Dr. Ashish again in Delhi. So see, look at the power of technology and the way it has really come up. And see, since it does not have any boundaries, so ageless. And a professor from Bhopal is, she has a cushion also about technology. So how wonderful is the whole thing? And when we talk about Swayam, we say it is for aspiring minds and young people. So it is ageless, it is timeless. At this hour of the day, it has galvanized so much energy, so much action, so much learning. So it is truly something stupendous, something fantastic which is happening. And thank you, Semka, for igniting this whole thing. And thank you, Uttarakhand Open University, our very own, for this whole thing. And very, very clearly, my closing thing, because most of the time we talk about it. These days in 21st century, we talk about these educational skills. So for sure, MOOC is one. And Swayam, of course, is the platform. So need is there to, you know, get acquainted with this thing, because ultimately we will have a useless class, we say, and we will have a kind of, you know, enlightened class. It is not something which sparks some kind of a controversy, some kind of debate as to what this enlightened class is. This class is, which is digitally active, which is digitally, you know, it is empowered. And a class that knows how to use technology in order to reach out to people, to empower them, to enable them. So there's the whole crux of this discussion. It was wonderful connecting with you all. And thank you very much, Dr. Jitin, Dr. Manas, and Dr. Maithili, and all our Dr. Ashish and Dr. Ghosh. They are all wonderful people. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. So now, on behalf of Uttarakhand Open University and our collaborator Simka, and on my own behalf, I thank all the panelists and the participants to make this program a success. I wish you all a wonderful learning experience. Thank you very much. Now I am signing off. See you soon in the discussion forum.
Thank you.
Thank you.